This video is going to show you how to draw a plane and its pole on the stereograph. And remember, a plane will dip in a particular direction and its pole is at right angles to the plane. And if you think about it, the pole is also exactly opposite the dip line. Now we are going to draw a plane that is striking 120 degrees and it is dipping 60 degrees to the northeast. To do this, the easiest way when you're learning is to hold the tracing paper steady, because that's your geographic coordinate system. So keep north heading up the table and you'll always know where you are in space. Use the stereo net and turn the AB line, which is your strike line, to the position of the strike 120 degrees. So we rotate around until that AB line is exactly at 120 degrees, which it is there. Now you can see my strike goes from 120 to 300, both are valid directions for strike. And I've now got a whole range of planes that are oriented parallel to strike, and I can pick the one that dips 60 degrees northeast. Remember, we read dip on the XY equator. And I pick the equator that is in the northeast quadrant of my compass. And I count down 60 degrees. So here's the XY line, the equator, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. And this, then, is the great circle that represents the plane that strikes 120 and dips 60 northeast. Now, if you remember, the pole is at right angles to that plane, but it is 90 degrees away, so you sweep out 90 degrees along the equator. So, going away from that dipping plane, count 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, and the pole is a line, so it plots on the stereograph as a point, and we label it P, going from three dimensions to a two-dimensional representation of our three-dimensional geometry. Now if we have a look at that, here now is our stereo net with our plane that is striking to 120, dipping 60 degrees to the northeast.